So in my talk today, you know, I will be sharing about what is Gutenberg and you know, what are the activities going on around it and what is the next movement which is happening around it. And including that, you know, after discussing everything, you know, let us look at a couple of challenges and opportunities around it, which you can explore and take advantage, right? As a individual, as a developer, or as a business entrepreneur, you know, how you can take those advantages around Gutenberg. So that we will be discussing. So before we start, Anju has already introduced very well for me. I'm Aslam Multani. I am Chief Operating Officer and founder, co-founder at Multidot Solutions Private Limited. Along with that, you know, I declare, you know, myself as a WordPress fan who wants to grow the list of WordPress fans, right? And you know, I'm connected with WordPress since the beginning of my career, and you know, as that belief, you know, what I believe is, you know, I have to give back to community, right? And as a step forward to that, I had been part of a meetup organizing team in Ahmedabad, and I had been, you know, part of organizing team for the WordCamp Ahmedabad last year, 2017. So, you know, before we start with the talk, you know, let us do a small activity where I wanted all of everyone's interaction. I want you to go to a website called menti.com on your phone, on your laptop, and you know, it will ask you a code. You see this code on the screen. It is basically an audience poll which will be asking you two questions. Tell me something about yourself, where you know, I have come up with a very limited option. Either you are an entrepreneur or you are connected to WordPress in one or other way, like developer, QA, designer, front-end developer, or you are just a WordPress fan who is using WordPress for you know, his corporate website or blogging purpose and all. So try to open that website. In the meantime, I'll open it on the laptop too. So Ravi, you want to go on the screen? Yeah, present. Skip the presentation. Okay, so we are, Ravi is trying, no worries. You skip the presentation. So it is a live polling. So as soon as Ravi manages it, let us look at the live results, right? So everyone is able to get it, right? Okay, and I wish everyone tries that. No, just a minute. Yeah, there you go. You click on the present. Okay. Well, okay, still the numbers are coming up. We have total 270, okay, 282. Interesting. Let us wait for 1 minute on this slide. 290 people, amazing. Okay, so we have a developer community coming up at 206. Okay, we have WordPress fans, 170 people. 88. Okay. Let us clap as we cross 300. You. All right. So what we see here, you know, we have developer community coming up. Let us move on to the next slide. No, no, not slide, sorry. The next screen. You click here. Yeah. Okay. So I ask this question on the Gutenberg. So the second question is about Gutenberg. At what level you know about Gutenberg? It is just you have heard about it, or you have literally installed it, or you have used it on your website, you have played with it, or you don't know anything about it. Okay. So there we have, you know, the overall bifurcation, and that is helpful. Let us move on to the slide. We'll keep this number in mind. Thank you. Okay. So the big question is, what is Gutenberg? And before starting to discuss the technicality behind it, let us discuss about an interesting, you know, person whose name is Johannes Gutenberg. So he is a person, you know, back in 14th century, where he invented a printing press machine. So earlier than that, you know, there was no mechanism to print, you know, books or any material through automation. That said, that there was no automation possible. Like, it was literally like people have to write books and then you distribute amongst the community. So printing press innovation was the changing one, and then there has been a lot of stories around where, you know, they first printed Bible through the printing press machine and they mass distributed it, and then all the different innovations happened around the printing which we are experiencing nowadays. And by taking the inspiration from Johannes Gutenberg, the new editor that is coming up into WordPress, you know, that got its name, which is Gutenberg Project. So, you know, again, you know, let us look at the current challenges that we have. So WordPress has been into the ecosystem since last many more years, and one of the dominating editor has been the classic editor. And you know the classic editor very well, where, you know, it has been operating very well and people are very much used to that. But looking at the recent advancements which are happening into user experience and user interface, where, you know, updating content, publishing content, there has been a lot of innovations. And now is the time where, you know, new level of UI is required. And WordPress also has to take participate in this entire journey. That is where, you know, if we observe, there has been a lot of challenges with the classic editor, where, you know, if you want to interact with the content, you have to maybe go into a technicality where you have to play with the short codes, or you have to play with, you know, CSSs, or you have to play with the code if you want to achieve the final result. At the same time, there is another challenge of WYSIWYG. So we call classic editor as a WYSIWYG editor, which is what you see is what you get. But unfortunately, you will also admit that it is not 100% what you see is what you get. Because, you know, when you implement a short code, you cannot see the end result in while you are editing the content, right? And the end result will be visible when you go to the front-end website. And the clear examples are short codes, where you put the short code and the compiled output. To see the compiled output, you have to go on the front-end website. So considering that, we see that instead of, you know, let's say considering it as a limitation of classic editor, we see that there is a lot of opportunity, a lot of enhancement which is possible into the classical editor. And that is where the entire idea of Gutenberg as a project, as a new editor, comes into the picture. Yeah. So for those, you know, who have heard about Gutenberg but haven't played with it or do not have the idea, for them, I will share a couple of ideas around it. Gutenberg is the brand new editor which is coming up into WordPress, and it is considered to be one of the biggest release so far, where, you know, the WordPress founder, Matt Mullenweg himself, is directly involved into the project, and I guess he is also leading the entire release of the project as well. Right. And, you know, the interesting thing is that while, you know, I was, you know, looking at my presentation yesterday, you know, I saw a Q&A post from Matt, which he, you know, released yesterday only. The Gutenberg project is into development since January 2017, and it has been almost like 1.8 years where the project is there. And during that time, it has faced a lot of development challenges, and it is an outcome of, you know, more than 200 contributors who have contributed into this entire project. The main idea behind Gutenberg is blocks. So this is a little bit technical term, where this entire editing of Gutenberg is going to be around blocks, where this entire interface will be achieved through blocks, where you can utilize the entire editor. One of the challenges that we discussed from the classic editor is inline editing, or what you see is what you get interface. And that is something which will be resolved with the Gutenberg editor. And another very interesting aspect here is that Gutenberg is the only project which is entirely built on JavaScript with React.js, right? So, you know, that is the example where you can feel that, okay, WordPress is also, you know, getting into the competition, and to cope up with the competition, WordPress has to, you know, work with, utilize the power of JavaScript. And as I mentioned, you know, my talk is more about discussing the high-level challenges and opportunities around the Gutenberg project. So I will not be discussing the hands-on demo or hands-on knowledge about the Gutenberg. But if you are more interested to know on that, I request you, there is a lot of material available on the web and around the community, and it will be pretty easy to find materials about it. So, when I say challenges, you know, I will also interpret them as opportunities going further. So, you know, if we talk about Gutenberg, then it is going to be a new way of editing for authors and publishers, right? So, imagine like WordPress is covering more than 30% market share around the web, right? And considering that, there will be, you know, a lot of people who are using the current WordPress editing interface, and they are habitual to that. So one of the challenge which I see is that, you know, adapting that, the Gutenberg, the new way of editing content and publishing them, that is going to be a challenge. And this is one of the reason of resistance. Like, people might be resisting this new change of Gutenberg because they might have to learn the technicality, the way, you know, it is a completely different way of managing the content. So that is one I have laid out as a challenge. One of the challenge I see is a backward compatibility of the Gutenberg project. As you may know, you know, WordPress is very much, you know, popular. WordPress is very much known about its backward compatibility status, right? Where WordPress, you know, all the time will first think about backward compatibility of whatever releases they make it, right? And it is the same case for Gutenberg project also, where they have already took care about the backward compatibility by creating a classic plugin editor. So let us say if you do not wish to continue with the Gutenberg editor, you can install a classic plugin classic editor plugin in your website, and if you have installed that plugin, you know, it is not going to create, not convert your website with Gutenberg. So that WordPress has already took care about it, but I have considered it as a challenge for business plugin developers, theme developers, or business owners who have built their business around WordPress ecosystem. Imagine that Gutenberg being such a large, you know, project, and obviously if you think, it is going to take time to roll over, right? It is going to take time to get 100% accepted by the community. So let's say people who are getting introduced to WordPress after launch of Gutenberg, they will be pretty compatible with Gutenberg and they will be using the editor. But imagine the scenario where people have a, you know, heavy websites who are already dependent on classic editor and lot of other plugins, where, you know, the compatibility with Gutenberg will be taking a lot of time for them. And the same case will be for plugin developers or products which are built already there. So the entrepreneurs have to consider this case where, you know, they have to make sure that the product that they launch, you know, either they want to make it compatible with both the plugins, both the editor version, because they will have customers who are using, you know, classic editor on their website, and they will have customers who are on Gutenberg. So it is a scenario where, you know, maybe if you have a customer base where both these probabilities are 50-50, then imagine you have to invest your development time for your product for being compatible with both the plugin, both the editors, right? It is pretty similar what happens when you develop an app for iOS and Android both, right? Like you have to develop both. That is the scenario. That is why I have considered it as one of the challenge. Yes, Kavi? Okay, so this third slide I have put it here, not as a challenge, but I'll say it is as an opportunity for us as a community member, as a developer, to contribute into the Gutenberg project. As I mentioned, this project has been into the development since January 2017, and there has been a lot of contributors who are working on this GitHub repo. If you see the current repository, there are around 1,300, this is the screenshot I took yesterday night. It is around 1,300 open issues out there, and still there is a new enhancements to go. So, you know, looking at this, where, you know, yesterday in his post, Matt yesterday already mentioned that Gutenberg joining the WordPress core with release of WordPress 5 is actually not the end. It is actually the beginning of the entire new era around the WordPress with this new editor, right? So imagine that whatever the level of editor is right now, there will be a lot of, you know, changes will be upcoming, and there will be a lot of opportunities where, you know, Gutenberg can help and change the way people, you know, publish content or, you know, manipulate or interact with the content. So I urge everyone to, you know, whatever way you can, to contribute into the Gutenberg, you know, development. Either may it be in a way of testing, may it be in a way of, you know, solving issues or reporting issues. You know, please contribute in your as possible way. Let us look at the opportunities after this discussion. Yeah. Utilizing the power of JavaScript. So as I mentioned, Gutenberg is completely developed upon JavaScript, React.js, and you know, if you all follow Matt's blog or Matt's you know, word of state, you know, in 2015 he urged the entire community to learn JavaScript, right? And that was a hint for the entire development community to that WordPress is doing something amazing with JavaScript, and Gutenberg is the proof where, you know, people, developer has this opportunity to learn JavaScript, and, you know, using the power of JavaScript again is an opportunity. So consider, you know, the capability of JavaScript, and Matt has a vision where WordPress, you know, down the line will be acquiring more and more the JavaScript interfaces. And there is a talk also going on about that WordPress admin is going to be completely based upon JavaScript, right? So this is why I have considered it as in one of the opportunity where it is like developers have the opportunity to learn JavaScript, as well as, you know, JavaScript developers can join the WordPress community too. Yeah. Yeah, it is all API driven. That the Gutenberg is built up on React.js, where you know, most of the interaction happens with API. Let us take an example of a simple block, where the block is, you know, let's say it is showing the latest post. So with the Gutenberg, when you drag a block in your editor, it will actually compile, show the actual 5 latest posts in your editor, and you can see that all the posts come, you do not have to go to the front end. That means the API is already there. Means in future, if you plan to create a mobile application, or if you want to publish, share your content with any third party tool, it will be possible that API is already there. You do not have to develop that. evolution of blocks. So as I mentioned, blocks is playing a very important role into the Gutenberg editor. There has been a lot of talks going on where, you know, blocks will be coming up in form of nested blocks, child blocks, dynamic blocks, and around that there will be templates and layouts. So imagine that blocks will have capabilities where you can limit certain conditions. For example, imagine you are creating a contact form block where you want to restrict the admin that under this contact form block, the user can only create certain blocks. That means you cannot add all the blocks. In the coding, you can specify that condition. And having all such power to the WordPress developers, imagine what kind of complex, what kind of very easy interface you can create for the publisher, for the admin, and what level of products you can develop. And that is interesting talk is going on about the templates, where templates will be playing a very important role. So imagine a scenario where the new versions of future themes will be very similar, where themes will not have any blocks into them, but all the blocks will be from Gutenberg and plugins which the admin is using for their website, and themes are only the CSS styling and templates. And as admin uses a theme, his websites will be rendered on the front end. And developers will have the power to lock the templates. So you can create a template where the admin cannot delete the slider. He can just only edit the content, but he cannot delete it. That way, you can prevent user-generated errors when they play with the admin panel. Yeah. So in this slide, I have put one screenshot which I took with a reference from a talk in the WordCamp Europe from Matthias Ventura. He is the team lead for the Gutenberg project. And I'm sorry, it is not visible here, but the screenshot is saying that the new way of creating a page will be like, as soon as you click on the add new page, there will be an interface where you can select the template, and then you can create the page that way. Yeah. As I mentioned, the editor is just a start. So the future vision of WordPress ecosystem is pretty similar, where this block mechanism is right now only limited to the post content, but the future vision is to expand that capability outside the post content area as well. That means in the future you will be seeing that the current customizer which is there, it will be giving the capability to the admin where he can utilize the blocks into the header, into the sidebars, or into the footer as well. And in the widget area, you can also create new blocks. That means you can utilize blocks everywhere. And it is like, every piece of your website will be, managing through a small object called block. Yeah. Okay, what is next? Listen. Okay, so with this, as I mentioned in my GitHub screen, that, I urge the entire community to try the Gutenberg, taste the Gutenberg, and contribute to it. So, think about it where you can take the opportunity as an early bird into the Gutenberg project and try it, taste it, and contribute it. Prepare your customer. So by trying and tasting, you are ready for Gutenberg. But at the same time, for agencies and developers, you have to prepare your customers, right? They will be resisting this change. So how you can prepare your customers? So maybe you can build seminars, you can schedule workshops, you can publish content, you can create tutorials, and you can generate this awareness about this editor amongst your customers so that they feel comfortable and they know what is Gutenberg. Okay, so with this slide, I would like to say, as the latest news, Gutenberg is going to join the WordPress 5.0 very soon. It will be joining the core, and that is the that is the sign that, okay, this project is moving ahead. So what I want to request you all is, don't wait for the Gutenberg to go away, you know, because it is something, you know, interesting happening with WordPress, and you know, it is not going to go away. So better you jump into that, you take the early bird advantage, and you know, get flexible with it. Yeah. So with this, I would like to read a small paragraph from Matt's post yesterday. He said that, I knew we would be taking a big leap, but it is a leap we need to take. And I think the end result is going to open up many new opportunities for everyone in the WordPress ecosystem. And for those being introduced to WordPress for the first time, it brings us closer to our mission of democratizing publishing for everyone. Thank you. I think I don't have time for questions. Do I have a question? 3 minutes? Thank you. So that was it. Questions, please. Yeah.
I'm having a question, actually. I'm from sales and marketing, mm-hmm. So I want to get the advantage of early bird, as you said, from the Gutenberg experiences. Mm-hmm. I also have a small team, but they're not familiar with the JS, and as you said, mm-hmm. and React.js.
Yeah.
So, I mean, what is the best way to get quickly through the React.js and get into the Gutenberg? What is the best way to achieve or to contribute or try to test it?
Sure. As I mentioned, the best way, of course, will be to learn React.js gradually, because you know that is the ultimate way. But you know, as I said, Gutenberg has been there since long, and there has been a lot of, you know, boilerplate plugins and boilerplate scripts has been built up there. So if you are planning to, you know, explore how to create blocks or what is the complexity behind it, you know, there is a material available on the internet, and once you are comfortable with the boilerplate, you do not have to actually go into the complexity of how to register a blog or what are the different properties and attributes out there, but you can just use the boilerplate and you can actually start working on the business logic of the solution that you are looking for. Yeah, I hope that answers the question. Yeah please.
Hi, Aslam. This is Maruti, and thanks for a great talk.
Thank you.
I would like to just put the question on the floor, which is always there. Do you think it is a great time for Gutenberg to be included in the core within 5.0, or do you think it's not ready, or do you think we should be given enough time, like people are talking about putting it into the core in January or in maybe mid-January, and do you think it's ready? Do you, being a person who is like following Gutenberg so keenly and closely, do you think it's ready and should it be put into core with 5.0, which is, I guess, within a week or so?
Yeah, so, you know, maybe, you know, I will answer it this way, that from this post which I read yesterday, you know, where Matt is mentioning that, you know, one of the learnings they have was, you know, they announced the dates very early, where, you know, a couple of things came later on the Gutenberg. So, you know, now they are trying with the release candidates, and they are, you know, taking some time to have, they feel the Gutenberg is stable at the moment, but still they are working on these recent open issues, and they will be taking some time to integrate into the final release. But until that time, they will be testing it on the release candidates. So that will be like 5.01, 02, or 03, and then they will be merging it. And you know, one of the challenge would be, you know, backward compatibility. So which I guess, you know, they have been, you know, I'll not say warning everyone, but they are helping, they are telling everyone to, you know, install the classic editor plugin if you don't want your website to be migrated to Gutenberg. So I guess they are, you know, very much taking care of anything bad would happen. So that is a good time, I guess. Thank you, everyone. And thank you for listening to me. Thank you.